I used to see black spots on the lungs of mostly smokers. Over the last decade or so, I saw a series of teenagers with black spots on the lung. And I thought to myself, oh my God, what's happening?
What could be causing this epidemic of lung disease? The answer, it turned out, was in the air.
In India, the bulk of pollution comes from crop burning, garbage being burned, vehicular pollution, and industry, which releases tons and tons of toxic smoke into the air. I have seen it with my own eyes. We need to do something about it.
Fossil fuel combustion is a main cause of air pollution in India and around the world. It's also the biggest driver of climate change.
The bushfire experience across Australia was an extraordinary experience. We had weeks and months in some places of hazardous air pollution and poor air quality. Some thousands of people were in hospital with heart disease and arrhythmias. They had heart attacks and strokes. We know that lung infections and pneumonia is made more likely by exposure to pollution of that nature.
Health professionals are realizing that climate change is one of the greatest health threats of the 21st century.
Climate change is fundamentally a public health issue. We know from ample evidence that we are in a critical moment when it comes to climate action. And unfortunately, the healthcare sector, both in the US and around the world, is a huge contributor to global greenhouse gas emissions and climate change.
If healthcare was a country, it would be the fifth largest climate polluter on the planet. And if we're going to protect people's health from climate change, we need to move away from fossil fuels.
The sector needs to take action to reduce its own emissions.
These are doctors from all around the world tackling climate change as a public health crisis, while also bringing sustainable practices to a major contributor to climate change: healthcare.
I do get asked sometimes, why would a pediatrician be involved in climate action? I feel that it is my duty to think about what are the factors outside of my clinic that really are contributing to my patient's well-being. If the operations of healthcare delivery are doing harm, that seems completely antithetical to the oath that I took.
What we need to do is really reinvent healthcare in the 21st century.
Overall, the biggest source of healthcare's climate footprint is the sector's use of fossil fuels, whether it's burning fossil fuels on site to produce energy, whether it's buying energy produced by coal, oil, and gas, or whether it's in the supply chain, which is a huge part of healthcare's footprint.
What's shifted for me in the last year or two has been the profound recognition that climate change affects us now. If we were better at addressing disease before it gets to the point where people end up in hospital, then we can significantly decrease the carbon footprint. We need to be proactive in taking that longer term view.
When healthcare providers realize that their actions and the sector that they work for is actually contributing to the burden of disease, they're ready to take action.
The whole debate about climate change is live in our community. There has been a central commitment that the NHS will meet net zero by 2050. We employ around 1.7 million staff. I think we're the fifth biggest employer in the world. We're responsible for about 5% of the UK's carbon emissions. At Newcastle hospitals, we now recycle 43% of our non-clinical waste. 60% of our staff come into work using sustainable modes of travel, and we've banned use of diesel and petrol cars in our fleet.
Doctors, nurses, hospitals, and health systems in more than 70 countries have joined together with the international network Healthcare Without Harm to build a global movement for sustainable and equitable healthcare, for clean air, and for a healthy climate.
If we look at this health and climate change dynamic, we see hope. We see hope because individual action makes a difference to your health and well-being.
So the first step to solution is to become aware, awakened, and then only the action will come.
Health professionals today who are interested in climate action have so many opportunities to get involved that relate to energy efficiency, clean energy, sustainable purchasing, healthier foods. We're very powerful as exemplars for our patients.
Two of the greatest health threats of the 21st century are climate change and a global pandemic. And we've got one on top of the other.
I am optimistic that if we can contend with one threat at the moment, we can probably contend with a whole series of threats at the moment. It's the most extraordinary time to be imagining the human future.
If you want to have healthy people, you need to have a healthy planet.
For more on how health professionals are advocating for a healthy planet and what you can do, please visit healthforclimate.org.